Welcome to Your 20-Minute Podcast with David Brower, where we do our best to give you useful information in 20 minutes or less. Now, here's your host, five-time Voice Arts Awards nominee, David Brower.
Thanks, Alan. This is David Brower with your 20-Minute Podcast. Our special guest from New Jersey today is Stacy Chalemi. She's a popular, recognizable health, lifestyle reporter, expert, columnist, health host, and the list goes on and on. Most recently, she's the author of The Complete Guide to Natural Healing and Natural Remedies for Common Conditions, along with 20 other published books. Stacy, welcome to the show. Good to have you here.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
You bet. So how did this world of natural and health healing and all that good stuff, where did all that happen in your life?
Well, it began, when I was in, I developed epilepsy at the age of 5, and I struggled all my life dealing with the endless seizures that, my life was pretty much like a roller coaster ride.
Yeah.
And when I got into college, it was difficult because in college, as you know, that you have the late night studying, you have the stress of trying to get those grades in. And I was having a really difficult time, I had written an article, and they had published it in the Epilepsy Foundation magazine. And I asked people how they dealt with their epilepsy, and I asked them to let me know some of the ways that they cope with the illness. And
nice.
To my surprise, I had 300 to 400 people write letters to me and contact me, and it was amazing some of the stories I heard. I was really, really motivated, and it really gave me the inspiration to really move forward. And what I did was I took a lot of those letters and I took a lot of the advice a lot of people gave me, and I wrote my first book called Epilepsy, You're Not Alone. And
mm-hmm.
It took me about 7 years to put that book together. And I had wrote that book, and it did really well. And then as time went on, I was still dealing with trying to control my seizures. And I started working with an herbalist, and the herbalist had me do a lot of research on all different types of illnesses and different areas of the health industry.
Mm-hmm.
And as I was doing a lot of research, I was utilizing a lot of that information and applying it to my own life. And my seizures went from 9 seizures to 5 to 4 to 3 to 2 to none. And it was my whole life kind of like did a whole turnaround. Now, I still take medication.
Sure.
I still go to my doctor, and but I incorporated a very healthy lifestyle, and I changed the way I live. I changed the way I focused on things. I incorporated, I incorporated different things like yoga, meditation, different herbs, supplements, detoxifying my body. And then
wow.
I started a blog, and I started writing about it and telling people. And, I started a little blog on Blogger on Google, and it was, I had about, it started with 400 people, and then it grew to 10,000, and then I started a website, and then the website grew to over 100,000 people coming on the website monthly to find out more about different type of health topics. And then I was starting to work with different professionals, and we were all working together and putting content on the website and doing radio shows and talk shows. And I did a lot of different things to, show people how to incorporate health into your lifestyle, and how it helped me, how it helped others. And it's just been an ongoing journey. And
my
it's been...
What a rush, what a thrill, what excitement. And it's not, and with over 20 books, and I think last I saw you had 300,000 people a month going on, or a day, is it a month, a day?
A month, yeah.
Yeah, 300,000 people a month going to your website, thecompleteherbalguide.com. But it's not just a story of epilepsy, not to minimize that, but your herbal guide touches on, almost 100, if not over 100 different things
that
might be questioning about, right?
Yeah, because, that's what motivated me. I was like, if it could help me with my illness, why
right.
couldn't it help someone with diabetes? Why
right.
couldn't it help someone with a sleep disorder? Why
yeah.
couldn't, you could apply, healthy living to anything. And even if you're healthy and you everybody has something.
Right.
But if somebody just wants to tweak themselves and just feel a little bit more energetic, or, you know, if somebody's just looking to focus and try to be more positive, you can really, you know, by changing your lifestyle and changing the little things, you know, some little things in your life, you could actually turn your whole life around. Everybody has the ability to become healthier, to become happier, to live a productive life. It's just learning how, and the thing is, where do I start? You know, where do I begin? And that's what my website's about, and that's what I try to do, is I try to teach people how to begin and how to focus and how to start and how to change themselves. If you're willing to change and you want to live a better, healthier, you know, more productive life, you know, you can do it. There's no such thing as no.
No question. A great place to start is when you go to the website, thecompleteherbalguy.com, and click on Start Here, because it's very simple. It says, let us help you give your body the ultimate makeover. We're here to help you. But you can click on Learn How to Heal a Specific Condition. Click on Improve My Level of Fitness, My Nutrition, How to Make Quick and Easy Healthy Meals, Appearance of My... I mean, it just goes on. And it's so simple to access.
Well, thank you so much. You know, we tried to work on trying to help people, because, you know, a lot of people, everyone, you know, is into computers, but a lot of people don't, you know, aren't like so computer knowledgeable, or they get lost in a website and
Correct.
They just don't know where to go. And so we try to make it very simple. We try to put everything, you know, as easy as possible so anybody can utilize it and get the most out of it.
Absolutely right. And if you just go left to right across the menu, from Start Here to Fitness to all the different conditions, Living Healthy, CBD, which is a big deal here in Colorado, all kinds of different things. But you've got featured articles, you've got health topics, you've got videos, you've got, I mean, my goodness gracious, if you have any kind of, let me just open up your list here just for a quick second. I think I was looking at that for a second. It had like, here you go, health conditions A to Z, right? So.
Right.
You just plug in, type in, let's see, I got blisters. Okay, I'll type that in. I got Lyme disease. Okay. I got PTSD. Okay. I got tonsils. Okay. And you just, my gosh, the list is endless. And the detail and simplicity of how you exchange this information is just invaluable.
And what's great about it is that we work with so many different professionals and people who work with us, and, you know, they're able to, you know, access their knowledge, and they're able to give, you know, their insight and help others as well. So the work is coming from, you know, everybody, from all you know, from all different, you know, in people in the health industry, and it's amazing, from, you know, people who specialize in different things, what they're able to access and give and to, you know, to help others as well.
Well, that's the other list. I mean, if you click on experts, you've got acupuncture experts, parenting and child care, yoga, hypnosis, hormone, chiropractic, food addiction, just tons of information. And it shows all the how you can contact everybody, the different kinds of life coaches. I can't imagine how much time, energy, and effort it took to put all of this together with all of these experts and make it so simple to follow. It's just, hats off to you, man. This is crazy cool.
Thank you. You know, we worked on it for about 10 years, you know, and we started from scratch, and, you know, we just keep, you know, we try, you know, to keep making, you know, putting more into it, you know, and trying to make it as best as we can for everybody, so everybody can, you know, get the most out of it.
Absolutely right. So, and you're on social media, I assume, everywhere, right?
Yeah, you can find us everywhere. Just put The Complete Herbal Guide and you'll find us.
So do you sleep like 2 hours a day, or do you have a herbal remedy for that? Or
my husband will joke with me. He says, apply what you teach, you know, because...
That's where I was going. That's awesome. That is awesome. The book, and again, there's 20 books here, folks. I'm just looking on Amazon, The Complete Herbal Guide, A Natural Approach to Healing the Body. Heal your body naturally, maintain optimal health using alternative medicine, herbals, vitamins, fruits, and vegetables. But also, as you said earlier, I mean, there's certain basic things that you keep in your life. You want to go to the doctor. You want to get your exercise in. You want to do your meditation. You want to do a whole variety of things that helps to give you optimal health, right?
Yeah, and you know, I tell people too, you know, you can't, you know, it's important to try to heal yourself naturally, but you also need to, you know, you need to go to your doctor and make sure when you're taking supplements and you're detoxifying that you're doing it the proper way. And that also people who take medications too, people don't realize, but supplements are just as strong as prescription medications. And a lot of times, like the pharmaceutical companies will even put supplements with their, when they're putting together the medications, they use supplements in a lot of their medications. It shows you, you know, the strength of these supplements. And so, you know, you have to make sure, like if you're taking a high blood pressure medication or medicine for depression or even for epilepsy or, you know, all different types of, you know, different medications, high, you know, cholesterol, mm-hmm. all these, a lot of medications could interact with supplements. So you have to make sure before you just, you know, not to just take anything, but make sure that, you know, you're able to take it. It's not going to interact with the medications you're taking. And you have to really, you know, keep a journal and see how you're feeling. You know, if it's not making you feel better, if it's not feeling good, don't take it. You know, you have to really be careful too. You know, you have to use your common sense too. And, you know, a lot of times you can read on the internet, you could read anything and you have, but you have to make sure what you're reading, who's writing it, you know, and I always like to even go to the medical journals because, you know, that's where everything is researched, that's where everything, you know, is accurate, and, you know, you can incorporate a lot of the medical research along with, you know, what you're trying to do. So if you're trying to, you know, let's say if you're trying to get, you know, work on fatigue and, you know, there's this something you want to purchase for energy, you know, mm-hmm. make sure, you know, this is something that's going to work well with your body. If you're taking medication, make sure it's not going to interact. You know, do your research and, you know, learn about the medications you're taking and make sure they don't interact, or call your doctor and ask your doctor if you're able to take something like this and it's not going to harm you.
Well, and I think, I don't know this for sure, but I think we know our bodies better than anybody else. So we have to be able to pay attention to even the smallest nuance of change mm-hmm. in how we feel, how we breathe, how we move, how we look, how our eyesight changes. I mean, there's so many things that can be affected by these things. One of the coolest things I found, purely on accident through my healthcare provider, was they offered a specialist who I could go in and sit down with my list of medications. Mm-hmm. And she would go through them one by one. We talked specifically what they were for, how they were doing or not doing, and most importantly to me, how they played well together. Did they play nicely together? Was one causing something that I wasn't aware of? I mean, that's...
Right.
And you alluded to that. That's a real concern that a lot of us don't pay attention to, I think.
Well, that happens to, you know, that's like the main thing, you know, and that's a discussion, especially in the health industry and people in the natural health realm as well. You know, people will go to the doctor, they'll get a medication, they'll start taking it. It will cause some side effects and they don't mm-hmm. realize it. They'll go back to the doctor and they'll say, you know, I'm feeling this, this, and this. Then the doctor will give them another medication for those symptoms. And before you know it, they have like five or six drugs in their medicine cabinet, and a lot of it is being caused by some of the medications they're currently taking.
Right.
And so, you know, you really need to pay attention, you know, is it the medications I'm taking that are making me feel like this?
Yeah.
You know, because there's always, you know, you always have to go back to the gut and really, you know, the core of, you know, there's
Absolutely.
Always something, you know, causing, you know, the original, you know, what the original thing is. You know, if you're suffering from something, well, something is making you feel like that.
Yeah.
What is it? You know, so you have to really go back to the core, the gut, and figure out what's making you feel like that, and just get a prescription to
well,
get
yeah,
better.
And I think that, and the gut is so right on, I believe. And the other part, I think, is I found this through my own experience. The I love my doctor. I've had him for years and years and years, and he just got busy, and so he handed me off to a PA, a physician's assistant.
Mm-hmm.
Love this guy, because he would take every possibility of any kind of suggested prescription, exercise, whatever, and he would write down on paper, black and white, okay, here's the different options, here's what this could do, here's what that could do, and we would talk through the possible side effects, the possible benefits, the possible whatevers, and it was like, oh my God, this is like layman's terms. I can make a really informed decision because you're taking the time to talk to me.
Right.
How often do you run into that, you know?
No, it's very hard sometimes, sadly, you know, because people are so, you know, doctors get so busy, and sometimes you'll sit down, they'll be in there for 5 minutes, and then they just write you quickly a prescription, and then they let you go.
Yeah.
You know, you need someone to really listen to you and really understand what you're going through. A patient and a doctor really have to have a good communication with one another, and you know, in order for, you know, for someone to feel better and get the care they need, they really need to have that patient and doctor relationship. And the
Absolutely.
Doctor has to realize that he got into this field to help people, and that's his prerogative. He needs to focus on the patient, and the patient also has to realize that he's not a god, that that you need to also do your own research, and you need to apply what you learn, you know, to your own lifestyle as well.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to, you know, the doctor can give you advice, but if you're not going to apply it to your life, and if you're not going to change your lifestyle to a more healthier lifestyle, then you're not going to get better.
Well, it's a partnership, right? You got to do the research. You got to trust people that you know how to trust. One of the things I found out, and I didn't know this, my PA and I were talking one day, and he was making my next appointment, and he told the scheduling nurse, he said, well, go ahead and give David the double appointment. And I'm going, what do you mean? Well, we're only allotted 15 minutes per patient, and I want to spend a half hour with you, so I'm going to take up two appointments. I said, 15 minutes? Are you kidding me right now? He said, no, that's all we're allowed.
Oh, wow.
I had no idea. And so he booked me two. Didn't cost any more. It just he knew that he needed to spend more time with me than
right.
what his normal allotted schedule would allow. And I had no idea that that was even on the table with these guys.
You know, it's sad, but that is so common in our life. You know, like in the health industry, people, doctors are only given so much time because they have
yeah.
so many patients that they have to see a day.
Yeah.
You know, and it's great that he did that for you, but you know, it's sad in a sense that they can only spend X amount of time with you because
right?
you might need more.
Yes.
You know. And also for people too, like, you know, people have to realize too that, you know, in order for them to get better, they have to also change their lifestyle and their way of living as well.
Yeah.
You know, you can't just rely on, you know, a medication or, you know, but you have to really understand that, you know, you have to change your whole lifestyle, the way you eat, the way you think, the way you do things, you know, the food you incorporate as well. You know, people don't realize it, but, you know, food plays a big part in our body.
Absolutely.
You know, so many times, you know, people, you know, they don't feel good, they're not getting better, and you ask them what they're eating, and you hear their diet, and it's like, you shake your head. Well, this is why you're not feeling good, you know?
Right, yeah.
And, you know, it was crazy, but like 2 years ago, I went to Europe, and I was there, and they cook very different than the Americans
For
cook.
Sure.
Everything is all natural and in the backyard type thing. And you know, a lot of the foods that we sell in America are banned in Europe. They don't allow those foods to come in Europe because the ingredients, some of the processed ingredients and the things they use are cancerous. And, you know, and so the companies in Europe, the laws in Europe will not allow our companies to sell those foods in Europe. And
I just
shook my head because, you know, they put arsenic in chicken, you know.
Yeah.
So that's why people say eat, you know, organic chicken because, you know, they do that so it's plump and it looks good and it stays fresher longer. But
right.
then we're taking that in our body and things like that are going into our system. And our body doesn't know what to do with these foods and, you know, these chemicals. And so they, it just stores it. It can't get rid of it. It can't break it down. And it gets stored in our bodies. And then our organs become sluggish and our body becomes, you know, we're not, you know, operating the way we should. We're getting headaches. We don't know why. And the whole thing starts. And then, you know, you start getting sick and, you know, illnesses occur. And it's something, you know, it's an ongoing thing where people have to realize that what we put in our body plays a big thing on our health. And people have to really start looking, if they want to feel better and look good and feel young and be young forever, they have to really look at what they're putting in their bodies.
Absolutely. Personally, I'm going to get your book, Be Kind, Over 300 Ways to Be Kind and Show Appreciation. I think that's going to be one of my favorites. So,
you know, I did that. So, you know, I did it for both adults and for children too, because I feel like, you know, in our society, we're such a rush society and we tend to lose you know, lose appreciation for what we have and the people around us, because sometimes you get so overwhelmed with so many things in our lives, we forget the most important things, and we forget, you know, to really be kind to the people around us, because they're the ones who really love us, and even strangers too. If you ever say, if you take the minute, like if you're going down the grocery store and you say something nice to the person ringing you up, you'll see their eyes light up, and you know, you might, you know, that those two or three words you say to them might make their day, you know.
Exactly.
Sometimes just the littlest things can just impact a person's life so much.
Well
so
said.
Sometimes just being a little, you know, kind and just showing a little bit of love to the people you love and to the and strangers around you could really, you know, make a life a whole lot different for everybody. And if everyone took time to do that, imagine what the world could be like.
Right? Stacy, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Listen to your 20-minute podcast with David Brower on the go. Downloads are available on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, iTunes, iHeartRadio, Spotify, any podcast app, and on our website at davidbrowervo.com/your20-minute podcast. Until next time, thank you for listening.